I grew up during the Apollo program, and even as a young girl in Colombia, I dreamed of becoming an astronaut. 40 years later, it's not clear to me whether I had fallen in love with the notion of going into space or the fact that something that everybody thought was impossible had been achieved. Today, we're faced with another seemingly impossible challenge. We need to disrupt and completely change our current carbon economy. That's easy to say, but it's quite difficult to do when you consider that fossil carbon is not just in gasoline or power. Fossil carbon is in everything we use in our daily lives. From the toys to the bed to the collar to the food of my rescued greyhound. All of this starts life in a refinery, in a central location based mostly on petroleum or natural gas. And it's all converted and then distributed around the world, creating the lives that we have and value today. Unfortunately, in 2021, this carbon economy is not fit for purpose because we now understand the impact of wasted carbon. Of putting carbon on a one-way street into our atmosphere, into our oceans. To me, every single carbon atom that goes into our atmosphere represents more people and creatures suffering, dying. We absolutely have to stop putting carbon into our atmosphere. And to do that, we need to completely change our carbon economy. So you ask yourself, how? This is surely an impossible challenge, but it's not. And the answer? The answer is waste. There is enough waste carbon already above ground to enable us to make all of the products that we use in our daily lives. Think about it. Think about how much carbon there is in industrial emissions, in farm and forestry waste, in garbage, and even in CO2 in our atmosphere. If we recycle the waste carbon from these sources, we would save around 7% of global CO2 emissions. It may seem like science fiction to use carbon again and again, but it's not. It's simply an idea based on nature, and it mimics the original carbon recyclers, trees. Consider that a tree not only recycles carbon from the air, but it recycles all its resources. Consider that when a tree loses its flowers, they're not wasted. They become food for the tree and even the next tree. In fact, nature served as the inspiration for an amazing idea that changed my life. 11 years ago, I was introduced to a scientist who had the notion that we could take waste carbon emissions from a steel mill and convert them into ethanol. He invited me to join his company, LanzaTech, and to help him scale the technology. And 11 years later, LanzaTech has been able to show that all of these waste emissions, not just those from the production of steel, can be converted to ethanol and then further to other products. What you're looking at here is a commercial gas fermentation facility in China that converts a steel mill off gas to ethanol. This plant started in 2018 and has already made more than 25 million gallons of ethanol and abated more than 130,000 tons of CO2. What's most important is that he was told this was impossible. He was told these gases are too dirty. Nobody has ever or will ever be able to scale gas fermentation. That this extreme industrial biology was impossible. But today, not only have we been able to do this at scale, we've been able to show that we can convert that ethanol to the products we use every day. That waste-derived ethanol is an intermediate to make all of the things that we need for our daily lives. In fact, with our partners, we've already made cleaning products, laundry detergent, clothing, shampoo bottles, and I've even flown on a transatlantic flight where part of the fuel was made from recycled steel emissions. Now, I want you to stop for a second and let your mind be blown away by this. Understand that every single one of these things was made from something that was going to be a greenhouse gas. And instead of allowing it to be pollution, we've converted into the things that would normally come from petroleum. And so I ask you to consider that waste carbon can replace fresh fossil carbon, and that we can make everything you need from waste. We're building plants all over the world to take waste resources to ethanol. In India, we have two projects, one that is taking agriculture waste that would be burnt in the fields, and another with Indian Oil using refinery emissions. These two projects will produce around 50,000 metric tons of ethanol per year using domestic waste carbon. This must be the future. I hope that I've shown you that everything around us, including the waste carbon in our atmosphere, can actually be the resource for everything you need, the resource that powers our new carbon economy. By disrupting our current carbon system, we ensure a livable planet for all. Let's rethink how we source, how we use, and how we dispose of carbon. And I urge you to consider that not only must carbon be reused once, but that after it is used to make one of your products, that the carbon in those products need to be reused again and again and again. This is the future we have to create, a future where there is no such thing as waste. This type of efficiency of resources, it's nothing new. Nature has always done it. We just need to learn to become more like nature. This is what we must do to bend the carbon curve, and it's certainly what we at LanzaTech intend to do. Thank you.